Hi everyone, my name is Vaishak and I'm a product lead on Google App Campaigns. In this video, we'll be deep diving on SKAdNetwork, also known as SKAN reporting in Google Ads. We'll cover the key SKAN report fields and how to analyze this data to measure campaign performance. Let's dive in. You can access SKAN reports in several places, including Google Ads, within your app attribution partner reporting, or using Apple or Google Analytics APIs. The report formats may slightly vary based on which source you use. Today, we'll focus on the SKAN report on your Google Ads interface. To find your SKAN report in Google Ads, first, head to the Insights and Reports section and select Report Editor. Next, scroll down to Goals and Conversions and choose the SKAdNetwork Conversions report. When you open the SKAN report, you will see a table. Each row labeled day shows data for each date, with the columns representing your different SKAN conversion values. A SKAN conversion value of 0 indicates app installs with no attributed post-install conversions. SKAN conversions with non-zero values represent installs with in-app conversions that you have configured in your SKAN schema. For example, in this sample account schema design, conversion value 1 may stand for account creation and conversion value 14 for an in-app purchase. As we have mentioned in previous videos, Google currently only supports fine value conversion reporting, even if you have set up your schema using SKAN version 4's coarse conversion values. If you would like to dive deeper into your campaign performance, you can also use these additional SKAN report fields. First, SKAdNetwork ad event type shows how users interacted with your ad. Here, interaction means they engage with the ad, while view indicates a view-through conversion. Next, SKAdNetwork attribution credit indicates if a Google ad was the last touchpoint. Here, 1 means Google Ads was the last touchpoint, while contributed means it was a top 5 contributor but not the final touchpoint. Finally, SKAdNetwork app campaign placement type denotes if the ad placement was on a web page or within a mobile app. You can use the app campaign placement field to identify the source app that displayed your ad. You can use these fields in the row section or as filters for deeper analysis of your SKAN report. Now, you might be wondering what these unavailable conversions are. This indicates that specific conversion value information was withheld due to not meeting Apple's privacy threshold. However, to help fill these gaps, we have launched a new feature in your SKAN report. This feature uses Google AI to redistribute the null data into known conversion values for more accurate and comprehensive reporting. To utilize this feature, apply a filter for SKAdNetwork attribution credit with the value set as 1. This ensures that the null redistribution is applied only to conversions definitively attributed to Google Ads. After doing this, you will see that the redistributed conversions will be allocated across your defined SKAN conversion values. Finally, let's look at a sample SKAN report and learn how to evaluate key campaign performance metrics like cost per install and cost per action. Before we do that, remember that SKAN conversions have post-pack delays and an inherent 30-day conversion window. Given this processing time, we recommend evaluating SKAN metrics every 30 days. If you evaluate SKAN reports on a weekly or intraday basis, it may result in incomplete conversion reporting for all networks. Now, let's calculate the SKAN cost per install for your iOS campaign. First, identify your total campaign spend for a selected duration. Next, sum the total number of conversions for all your SKAN conversion values from 0 to 63. This represents your total SKAN installs. Then, divide your total spend by total installs to calculate your SKAN CPI. Next, let's calculate cost per action or CPA for a specific event. First, identify total campaign spend for the selected duration. Next, find the total number of conversions for the SKAN conversion value mapped to your target event. Then, divide your total spend by the number of conversions for that SKAN conversion value to get your SKAN CPA. Please remember that SKAN has relatively short postback windows, often around 1 day, which may inflate CPA calculations. That wraps up our demo on evaluating your SKAN report in Google Ads. We hope this walkthrough helps you successfully analyze your SKAN reports and understand your iOS app campaign performance. Be sure to check out our other videos to learn more about SKAdNetwork fundamentals and how to drive better iOS measurement and performance. You can also find more resources in the description below.